In a previous video, I did share the idea that our universe may have its source in a digital workshop in cosmic consciousness. So I want to pursue that argument and propose to you. And remember, these are all models, right? These are all models. Ultimate reality is incomprehensible, but we do our best to try and understand it through models. So I want to explore with you the idea that our biology is digital and its relationship with the digital nature of the universe is a complementary relationship. And this whole process occurs in formless awareness, my favorite topic. In this playhouse of infinite forms, I caught sight of the formless, and so my life was blessed. It's a poem from Tagore. I'm looking for my little book of Tagore poems here. Here it is. Okay, so first, let's explore the digital nature of biology and the universe. And is this an emergence from formless awareness? The convergence of digital biology and digital physics presents a fascinating intersection of science and philosophy, suggesting that both life and the universe can be understood as informational processes. Let's explore the digital nature of biology, its relationship with the digital nature of the universe, and the philosophical notion that both could emerge from a state of formless awareness. First, let's discuss digital biology. Digital biology leverages computational techniques to model and understand biological processes. It involves the use of data science, machine learning, and simulation software to decode the complexities of life at a molecular level. This field extends to these days synthetic biology, where organisms are redesigned by altering the DNA to enhance or introduce new characteristics. For example, CRISPR technology allows precise editing of genetic material, revolutionizing medicine and agriculture. One of the most groundbreaking applications of digital biology is the direct storage of digital data in living cells. Researchers have developed methods to encode binary data into the DNA of bacteria, demonstrating the potential of biological systems to serve as data storage mediums. Human creativity is unbelievable, but I think it's an expression of cosmic creativity. In any case, this blurs the line between digital and biological systems, suggesting that living organisms themselves can be viewed as a form of information processing. What is digital physics? Digital physics posits that the universe operates like a vast computational device. This theory, initially proposed by Conrad Zuse and later expanded by others like Edward Fredkin, and of course, my favorite physicist, John Wheeler, who created the phrase the bit from the it, suggests that the fundamental processes of the universe can be described by computational rules akin to digital simulation. This concept aligns with the it from the bit hypothesis that I mentioned, which posits it from the bit. I would rather say bit from the it. It is the big it, and bit is the little bit, which posits that information is the fundamental building block of reality. One intriguing aspect of digital physics is its potential to reconcile classical and quantum mechanics. By adopting quantum computational rules, digital physics can address phenomena like entanglement and superposition, which is very mind-like, by the way. Entanglement and superposition, which classical computation struggles to explain. This approach could eventually lead to a quantum theory, even of gravity, bridging the gap between general relativity and quantum mechanics. But now let's go to where I want to go. And that is the idea that all form emerges from formless awareness. This is a philosophical perspective found in spiritual and metaphysical traditions, particularly in Vedanta and Buddhism. This concept suggests that the underlying reality is a state of pure potentiality from which all physical forms and phenomena arise. In the context of digital biology and physics, this notion can be interpreted as the emergence of complex systems and structures from a fundamental informational substrate. And what is the informational substrate? Formless. Formless. Quantum mechanics, of course, supports this view to some extent, as it describes a probabilistic universe where particles exist in a state of potential until observed. And this aligns with the idea that consciousness or awareness is or could be crucial in bringing form into existence. Of course, my friend Don Hoffman also proposes interface theory of perception and argues that our perception of reality is a construct of consciousness shaped by evolutionary processes to enhance survival rather than to depict a real fundamental objective reality. These days, there are many supporting theories and implications, most of which I don't agree with, by the way, because I'll tell you why in a moment. So first, there's the simulation hypothesis. This suggests that the universe could be a sophisticated simulation created by an advanced civilization. While distinct from digital physics, it shares the idea that reality is fundamental, informational. I think that's wacky, or even in today's language, weird. Okay, then there's the mathematical universe hypothesis proposed by Max Tegmark. I did interview him on YouTube some time ago, and you can find that interview. And this hypothesis posits that the universe is a mathematical structure, with physical reality being a manifestation of mathematical relationships. I am sympathetic to that idea because mathematics is an activity, in my view, in cosmic consciousness. Not everybody agrees with that. Then there's something called pan-computationalism. This view extends the concept of computation to all physical processes, suggesting that the universe itself is a computational entity. I've done a video on that also previously. In any case, these theories imply that understanding the universe and life as informational processes could lead to new scientific paradigms. For example, digital twins in biology and industry use computational models to simulate and optimize real-world systems, enhancing our ability to predict and control complex phenomena. As I mentioned, I have a digital twin myself, and you can engage in conversations with it by going to digitaldeepak.ai. But where do I stand in all this? I think all this is suggesting something very fundamental, and that is that what we call digits, zeros and ones, are metaphors for vrittis, vrittis in Sanskrit, which means fluctuations of consciousness. And they are subjectively experienced as sensations, sense perceptions, every sense perception is a digital phenomenon. So sensations, images, when you imagine something, that's a digital code in consciousness. And then sensations, images, feelings, they're also digital fluctuation, and thoughts. And that's what consciousness is. It's the source of sensations, images, feelings, and thoughts. And I would say a good metaphor then could be the digital nature of biology and the universe for understanding the complexity of life and the cosmos. And by viewing biological and physical systems as informational processes, we can bridge the gap between digital and natural sciences, leading, of course, to practical solutions in medicine, technology, and even environmental sustainability. But a deeper notion of formless awareness provides a deeper context, suggesting that all forms of existence emerge from a fundamental state of potentiality. And that state is pure consciousness, infinite, borderless, spaceless, fundamental, irreducible, incomprehensible, and unimaginable, but the basis of everything, everything that we call the experience of reality, the experience of reality. So I was hoping to find a more poetic expression of this, and I am looking at my collection of poems, and I find something that's very beautiful, because it talks about even the emergence of time from this spaceless and timeless fundamental reality that is consciousness. Let me read it to you. Time is endless in your hands, my Lord. There is none to count your minutes. Days and nights pass and ages bloom and fade like flowers. You know how to wait. Your centuries follow each other, perfecting a small wildflower. And we have no time to lose. And having no time, we must scramble for our chances. We are too poor to be late. And so it is that time goes by. While I give it to every querulous man who claims it, and your altar is empty of all offerings to the last. At the end of the day, I hasten in fear lest your gate be shut. But I find that yet there is time. Yet there is time. On many an idle day, I have grieved over lost time, but it is never lost. My Lord, you have taken every moment of my life in your own hands. Hidden in the heart of things, you are nourishing seeds into sprouts, buds into blossoms, and ripening flowers into fruitfulness. I was tired and sleeping in my idle bed, and imagined all work had ceased. In the morning, I woke up and found my garden full with wonders. This is how the formless, timeless expresses itself in the world of space-time and causality. So thank you for indulging me as usual. This is how formlessness can be understood as manifesting this theater of space-time and causality.